Hey, welcome all. Can you all hear me? Good evening, guys. Very good evening to everyone. So I hope you are ready to complete the quiz on the first chapter. Today we will be closing the first chapter. And likewise, your entire syllabus would be over one day. So that's really fun. So I really enjoy making the questions on your social science topics. So before we start, here is the screen shared with you all. Okay. Yeah. So I have started the sharing. Oh, can you all, you know, see the screen? Okay, here is the menti.com is the link. Code is 164424. Please mention your name and school as screen name. Okay? So let's say your name is Rajnikant. Then mention Rajnikant is INR. Okay? Okay. Yes, saliva. Saliva is in Indranagar these days. Who is saliva? Saliva. Yeah. Okay, we'll start with the mic on mute, guys. I can hear whatever you are saying on the other side. So, put your mic on mute. Here is the button. You can go against. This is the button here. You can mute yourself. Okay, so you have to. Yeah. Okay, no Taylor Swift and all. You have to mention your name. Okay, so if you have got some random name, just close that browser, open again. No problem. Everyone should be with his or her name. Okay, very good. Okay. So today's quiz is based on your second half of whatever we had, you know, let's say the first chapter we were discussing. The first half was done, 25 questions. Today also there will be 25 questions. In 25 questions, what I have done is I have tried to frame the answers which are typically there in your geography question, you know, portions, but same chapter. But then it will be more of research oriented, so, and some bit of application as well, some bit of knowledge application. Now, if you see the first chapter of 25 questions previously, 25 questions today. So these 50 questions are good enough to score any marks in any UT or any national international test if the chapter is same or the portion is same. So hence last 25 questions and these 25 questions, right? So total is 50 questions. Every chapter, just imagine if you have 50, 60 objective questions and your entire chapter is done, that's how the entire social science will be done. And then in a matter of few hours, so we spend 2 hours on first chapter. So there are 6 chapters in 12 hours, geography done. Similarly, no, I haven't started, Tanya. I haven't started sharing the. Okay, so now I hope everyone has joined and he has or she has put his name, proper name. Okay, so we have 65 people on board. We'll wait for a minute maybe if anyone wants to change anything. You don't require any pen and paper today. But if you want, you know, you want to record it, nothing like it. So, because all these questions will, as I told you, summarize the entire geography chapter for you, the first chapter. And if I were you, I would not have studied anything else but gone through the same 50 set of questions and done. Okay. Okay. How to record? You don't need to record. Record as in the sense, the questions which if you want to take down. Anyways, it will be available in the recording form. So later on also. So point being, the last 50 questions are good summary of the entire chapter, so you don't require anything else. Okay, so we'll just one more minute and we'll start. Yes, that's good enough to answer not all questions. Obviously, you have to explore more related to whatever is being given in the chapter. Okay. Yeah, the class is anyways getting recorded, Roshan. You don't need to record anything. Okay. So yeah. So if you have read it, most of the questions you will be able to do. You'll be able to answer. Right. And if later on also you can go through them, and then that will be okay. So okay. Now I think these many people only are going to join. So those who are going to join later will just. You just saw the question. Where did you see the question? In the back. Okay. Okay. So there are few minutes. I think people are trying to join in. So I will give them 1 minute benefit of doubt, and then we'll start. Okay. Okay. Next class. Maybe you can call your friends as well to participate, but then they will not be able to be in Mockstra group. They can play the quiz maybe. So we'll see if we can extend it to others as well. Okay, so shall we start, guys? So, okay, so those, that means 70 people were trying to join in. So I'll just give them one. Can we start? Yes, we can have Nick's history. Don't worry. Okay, so people are joining in and then going out. 1 minute. Jagrav says 1 minute. Okay, I'm giving you, chalo, 30 seconds more, 70 people, good number to play the quiz with. Okay. So you can open the browser to Google, you can open the book in front of you, you can keep someone who is knowledgeable in geography to answer your questions. But then at the end of the day, the intention would be to learn. Okay, what is this 14, 15, 16? Yeah. Oh. Okay, no cheating, meeting. Your agenda is learning. Wherever you learn, it's okay. I told you in my IIT, I don't know. I was telling you this HSR, only HSR people I told you this. That in our IITs, you will be allowed to answer a question with your laptop open, with your books. If you want to go to library and bring a book, that's allowed. Okay, so that's how, and you can spend whole night solving the question, and yes, if you can solve, then okay, never mind. So here we start, all of you, all questions from book you will see now. Start one of the countdown is 3, 2, 1, go. So the first question on board fire. Which of the following places doesn't have a water body named after it? So there is where the expanse will be, you know, now it will be. So it is lifted from the line in the book is that, okay, I'll not share that because it's still on. Okay, 3, 2, 1, and let me see who cracked it. Okay, so a lot many people have cracked it. That's nice. India has Indian Ocean, Persian Gulf, Panama Canal. Israel doesn't have any, you know, water body, famous water body, that is. If there is a Israel pond somewhere, I am not. Yep. So this is what is. Okay, so you understood the question. Okay. How is it?
Yes. Israel have a Dead Sea because it's close to Jordan.
No, you didn't understand the question. Question was named after it. Is it called Israel Sea?
Oh no, sorry.
Okay, so hence the question has to be read very, very.
So what's the code? I came late.
Code is 1644-24. So the question where I have no Persian Gulf. So I have taken the sources that the line in the book says that India is the only country after which an ocean has been named. So you can imagine the importance of the country. Okay, this mentioned in your book. But then I went outside it and try to find out which all countries have names for ocean and sea like that. Okay, here is the leaderboard. Okay, so Jayant is on the first place. Okay, Panama Canal is between North and South America. Okay, continent. Okay, anyway, so this is the first question. Next. Ready? This is directly lifted from book. Very, very easy question. So you'll never remember, never forget, sorry. Remembrance is important. Good Vedant, very good. Very, very easy, directly lifted from the book. If you read carefully. Very good. So here is the answer. No prize. Oh my God, still people have made it wrong. India. Okay, so hence India is having the longest coastline in Indian Ocean. Okay, so and we learned. Do you remember how much was the length of coastline of India? Last class it was, yes, very good. 7,516 kilometers, including the, no, 15,600 is the land boundary. 15,600 is land boundary. Do not get confused. Okay, next. Next. Oh, this is a leaderboard, sorry. So, Jayant is still maintaining the lead. Okay, that's cool. That's cool. No, not much of a shuffling has happened. Never mind. Let's go to the next question. Which of the following statement is are correct? Again, this could be a subjective answer to your geography question. 2 points in that. So what I'm doing is I'm converting each line of your geography text into question, and this is how we used to study during our 9th, 10th grade. So we have to convert everything into question, becomes very interesting. Okay, here is, oh, lots of people have done it wrong. This is directly lifted from your book. Why did you make it wrong? Okay, so I don't know if you see, do I locate it? There you go. This is a book and see how I have done it. Where was it? Downward. Here it is, I think. No. Where was that? I had lifted it from somewhere.
Sir, I have a doubt. How is Deccan Plateau useful in connecting India to the world?
See, note that the Deccan Peninsula protrudes into the Indian Ocean, thus helping India to establish close contact with West Asia, Africa and Europe from the western coast and with Southeast. See, this is written in your book. Okay.
Sir, but the book says peninsula and the question said plateau.
So, in
Sir, actually, the book won't provide a connection.
In the Southern Peninsula, we have only plateau, I believe. Right, we don't have any desert, any plain, any mountain. We have only plateau in southern part of India. So hence.
So okay. should we take the peninsula as plateau here?
No. See what I'm saying is, it is called Deccan Peninsula, but peninsula protrudes into Indian Ocean. What is protruding into Indian Ocean? Yeah. The Deccan Plateau itself is protruding into Indian Ocean, right? Because there is nothing else on this southern part of the peninsula, hence. Okay, so fair enough. No problem. Read. And here is the next. Okay. Close fight. That's interesting. Next question, guys. Ready? So today you will be finishing up the this is again directly lifted from the book. Control F. Someone was discussing in the group. Control F. But you will be astonished to know the idea is persisting since I think 2000 years. People were trying to make this canal, but they didn't have. Oh, did I? No problem. You learned, right? Never forget it. The idea is next time there is a question anywhere, whether it is NTSC or your school unit tests, perfect. Very good. So a lot of people either misclicking it or something else has happened, right? So do not forget, 1869 was the year. There was a company jointly owned by British and French. This thing, you can check it on the Wikipedia. They opened it or they made it. This is a man-made canal, by the way. Man-made canal, okay? So next. So this is the... So all of you have marked it correct only. That's nice. So no new entrant so far, okay? Yes. Okay, next. Now this is very, very easy. You know this. You must know this. Because there is a mention of Suez Canal in your book, you must know some bit of it about Suez Canal. Very, very important canal for the entire world, not only for India, for the entire world. If Suez Canal would have been, let's say, made in 17th century or 18th century, probably India would have been in much trouble. Okay, right. So the Mediterranean Sea and the Red Sea. Mediterranean Sea in the north, Red Sea between the Africa and the Asian continent. Okay, I'm not showing you the Red Sea right now and all that because there are questions, more questions. Okay, so let's see who. Okay, so fantastic. Who is on top right now? So Jayant still maintaining. That's cool. Keep it up. Okay, never mind. Let's go to the next question, guys. Ready? Focus. So, is in. A lot of people are very good at general knowledge, it seems. That's nice. Easy. So the control of Suez Canal was, you know, very important for many countries. Easy, right? It's not there in your book, but then the moment it is there, the moment you see Suez Canal, oh, Google it right before. Cool. That's nice. Okay, so most of you have got it correct. There is no debate on such questions. Okay, never mind. Now you know, Monisha. Which country? Egypt. Which famous river flows through Egypt? Name it. Let's see how many of you know. Oh, wow. So, Egypt is one of the oldest civilization. You know that. And because of the Nile. Okay. Which is the largest desert in world? Which is also closer to Egypt. Right? No, not Gobi. Gobi. Largest desert in world is Sahara or Antarctica? Which one is correct? Antarctica or Sahara? Antarctica should be the largest desert. Did I say hot desert? I just said desert. Right? So hence. Okay, so be careful about the question being asked. Next question, guys. Oh, before that, the leaderboard. Okay, so it's nice. That's nice. Good, Jayant. Nishant is giving good fight. Okay, next. Let me see how many of you get it correct. That will happen, Tanvi, my dear. Total attention. Total attention. Full focus. Read through. And these questions are at times confusing. Don't know. Oh my god. Mix. So only 15 people have. Yes, you should have got, you know, applied some logic. Why is it that Egypt is anyways connected through Mediterranean Sea to English Channel, or, you know, so hence there is no advantage between Egypt and England, right? Rest others. What is Cape of Good Hope? You know, Cape of Good Hope. So that was the problem when Vasco da Gama came to India from Europe. What did he do? He made a full circle. Yeah, tip of South Africa. So made a full round, then crossed Madagascar and then reached Calicut, I believe. Yeah. So that was the longest possible, you know. And someone was mentioning the other day that the Suez Canal reduced the distance between England and America. Sorry, not America. India and what is that? England and India by 7,000 kilometers. Okay. Here is the, yes, Sunaina mentioned. Yes, I know. Yeah. And it is mentioned in your book, by the way. So hence, next, the leaderboard. Oh, so people are okay. That's nice. There is some change now. Suranjita is in second position. Good. Never mind. Let's go to the next question, guys. All set. Here is the next question. So this is about standard. Meridian. We learned last class. What is the longitude? What is the value? Okay. Not many people have got it right. So what is the, you know, what is the latitude? Oh, sorry. Longitude for this. 82 degree 30 minutes. Remember that? 82 degree 30 minutes longitude, and it passes through one place. We had a quiz last time. What was the answer of that? It passes through Mirzapur. Wow, great. Yep, keep in mind. Next, let's see the leaderboard. Okay, now changing. Now things are changing. Cool. Okay, Jen still on top. Really, really. So Jen knows each and every question. And he's fastest too. That's nice. Okay, here goes the next question. Read the question carefully. And it's directly lifted from your book again. If you would have read, you will just click it. Oh, so variety of answers. Okay, how many of you did not read the question carefully? It said, which of the following statements are incorrect? It was not saying correct. It was saying how many of these statements were incorrect? And I know all of you have not read it properly, and then hence you had marked something else. Okay, yes. So that's what the intention of this question was. The answer was very much in the book. You might have read it also, but then in your temptation of doing it faster, you didn't read the question properly. Right? Okay, so hence, here is the leaderboard. All the three options were wrong. Right? because Indian trade route was facilitated through land routes, not never sea routes. Okay. Next question. Okay, before that. So I'll read the questions carefully. You will find that in my set of questions a lot. So whenever I will be asking questions, it will be, you know, designed to trap you. Okay, people are happy for Jayant getting it wrong. Don't worry. Next question is here on your screen. This is again lifted from your book. So if you have read the book, it will be there. Next time. Okay. Okay, so fair enough. That means lots of people have read. So religious ideas, obviously. And Buddhism and other things, scientific ideas we have studied in mathematics. The numeral system which the world uses is through that. Then spices, the famous spices, and art and culture. So most of our, you know, we have actually borrowed more than given to the world. So our art and culture, for example, all these Mughal architecture or let's say the Christian architecture, right? So all those we have borrowed more than given to the world in case of architecture. Okay, here is the next. Oh, before that, we'll read a board. Okay, so fair enough. So people have spent time to read and then, okay, that's nice. Good. Good, guys. Let's go to the next question. Next question. Here is the next question. Careful. This is again mentioned in the book, but the book is old. Yep. Yeah, so hence the question was to make sure that you have noted the change. Still, see, many people have made it wrong. So now we have 28 states and 8 UTs. Okay. So anyways, yeah. What happened? Yes. 28 states and no, the book answer is wrong. That's what you have to change it. Okay, 29 states no more after Jammu and Kashmir. So after in Jammu and Kashmir, let's say declared UT. So now there are two UTs over there. Okay, so now we don't have that. Okay, so here is the leaderboard. Oh, lots of people have got it wrong. Okay, 10 places. Very good. No problem. Ready for the next question? Here is the next question. Careful. Careful. Careful is the word. You can go to Google Maps and check it and mention and remember, but don't forget. If you forget, then first chapter only, yes. So there is an activity in your geography book. If you have read the activity which most of the people ignore, so cool. So most of you have got it right. Okay, so which all states, by the way? Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, and Odisha, West Bengal, right? Four states. None but these four states. another Indian territory is there in Bay of Bengal. In fact, two more, Pondicherry or Puducherry and Andaman and Nicobar. Right? So the chapter name is India, size and locations. We must know everything. Karaikal is part of Pondicherry only, Gandhar. So there are, you know, four districts of Pondicherry. Anyways, next, go to. Okay. Oh, Jayant could not answer this one. Jayant, what happened? So the people will be like now, but still. Oh, there is a change. Okay. Anuya is now on the top of the list. Great. Next, still halfway through, guys. Halfway through only. Yes, no problem. Yes, Tanvi. I also want everyone to be top, on top. How many? Same question, but now on the Western Front. This was easy. No, Andaman was not state, Monisha. I only said states. Okay, very good. Okay, so 34 people have got it. That's nice. So what all? Gujarat, Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Kerala. Everyone wants to Goa, but then you never count it as a state only. Yeah? That's so bad. Right? No, everyone wants to Goa, isn't it? So everyone wants to party in Goa, but never, no one. Okay, five. Correct? Okay, so here is the next. Okay, before that, the leaderboard. Okay, so Jayant again back. Okay, so change in positions. Okay. Next. Folks, let's go to the next question. So I don't know whether you know that there were more than 500 princely states before India got independence. So Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, the Iron Man of India, did a monumental work of integrating all the princely states into India. Okay, so Agra was very much part of, there was a presidency called Agra Presidency. Okay, so Agra was in the initial days itself. So you'll study in history, when I will do history, you will learn that Agra was, I think Agra became part of British India in early 19th century itself. Okay, so Agra was not a princely state. Bhopal was one. Junagadh was one. Junagadh is in Gujarat. And Mysore, you already know. No, this is not a history question, because there is a thing in your... again, there's a line in your geography first chapter which talks about princely states. So hence you must explore princely states. Okay, very good. So here is the next. So what all princely states were there? You should go and study. You just don't really learn it. Okay, there were princely states and then no. So hence to inculcate this habit of researching. Very good. So that's nice. Let's go to the next one. Now comes the main masala. Which of the following would you find between India and Sri Lanka? So everyone knows it. Everyone has gone there. Twenty-five, Nikita. OK, Okay, so very good. Let me see. Wow, most of you know it. That's nice. That's really nice. That's really nice. Okay, so where is Sir Creek? Anyone knows what is Sir Creek? Sir Creek is between. No. Sir Creek is a creek which is, between India and Pakistan. So, India and Pakistan are fighting over Sir Creek. So, it's a marshy land, and what happens is the course of the creek keeps on changing. So, India claims something, Pakistan claims something, and the international boundary actually goes through the middle line of the Sir Creek. Yes, Kutch in Gujarat, correct? No, it's not. Actually, it's a marshy land. It's a, it's a part of Ran. You have heard of Ran in Gujarat? It's a marshy land. Total marsh is there. No inhabitation is there. It's a, so estuary where water or let's say, water and sea, land and sea is kind of transitioning. So it's a marshy land, and there's a, international border passes through the middle line of that creek. So that is a disputed thing, and actually not disputed. It is India's thing, but Pakistan also claims it. Gulf of Cambodge and Gulf of Kutch are in Gujarat. No, Cambodge and Gulf of Cambodge is very famous. Why? Because we have found lots of reserves of shale gas. Do you know shale gas? So you know natural gas, right? You know shale gas, SHALE, SHALE. See, upcoming fuel, which is, so hence Gulf of Cambodge, just at the corner of Gujarat, and there's a sharp corner, right? In the map of Gujarat, there is where Gulf of Cambodge is. Lots of, yes, sedimentary rocks. Yes, correct. So learn, remember them. Okay, next. Here goes the next question. Okay, here is the leaderboard. Jayant is back again. Jayant is like stock market. Okay. Yes. This you all must be knowing. No prizes here. Most of you know it. Very famous. Very, very famous. Lots of time it's there in news. Lots of court cases also going on. You must read one newspaper. Okay? So, this is the. Okay? Nothing about famous, had to Google it. Okay. Right? Got it? So, hence, this is the. I'm not deliberating more on this right now because there will be a few more questions, and then I'll explain the entire story. What is this project all about? You must know. Okay, here is the. Very good. Very good. Okay, so here goes the next question. There is a question in your book around India's neighbors, and this is related to that. In geography lesson, there is a question on neighbors of India in the Indian Ocean. So you must know that. But I hope you have read the question carefully. Because in the question, it is south to north and not north to south. So I hope you have taken care of that, and Mauritius, Maldives, Sri Lanka. That's right. Okay, never mind. So Mauritius is way down in Indian Ocean near Madagascar. Maldives is very close to Sri Lanka, and Sri Lanka obviously is nearest, right? Nearest. Okay. You understand? Mauritius is very, very close to Madagascar, there, down south, near South Africa. Okay, never mind. Let's go to. So these are all information you must have. Where is India vis-a-vis? There is a, you know, island still occupied by British people in Indian Ocean. Do you know that? It's, yeah, where, yes, what is it called? The island is called. So you just, you know, there is a, no. That is a special, another country. There's another island which is occupied by, or let's say it's in British control, where lots of naval, you know, this thing is built up is there. So that's a very strategic location in Indian Ocean. So if at all tomorrow there is a unfortunate scene of world war, that particular island is going to be used a lot. Anyways, so here goes the next question. This is someone who knows only will be able to mark it. Guesswork. Hey, by in itna mein toh you can just go to the Google map and find it out. Oops. Most of you have got it wrong. Too fast, huh? Yeah, you can get the phone ready. No. Go to the maps. All these are related to maps. You must know your country well. Okay, so Gulf of Mannar is on the southern part, and I don't know if you know, Gulf of Mannar is very famous for few wildlife species. You know, sea cow being one of them, rare species, right? It's a marine national park over there. Okay, very very sea cow, dugong, very very famous species. Okay, and there is something called sea cucumber also. Yes, so these. Yes, dugong, correct. So check about it. You know, so if you, let's say if you get a chance to go to Rameshwaram, make sure that you, but right now it is closed. It's not, you know, public is not allowed there. It's very hot spot for biodiversity. Very, very rich in, you know, in bio, you know, wildlife. Yes, near Rameshwaram it is. Rameshwaram, you know, Rameshwaram is also a pilgrimage for Hindu people. Yeah. Okay, so next. Ram lives there. Oh my God. Okay, so now people are cool. Okay, so let's go to the next one. So here is the next question. So those who are aware of this, they will definitely mark it correct. Okay, see, most of you have got it wrong again. So the project has not been started, so it will, there is no question of completion. So it's only on paper right now. Yeah, so correct. So hence it is very much very very important project, because right now if you have to go from Mangalore to, let's say, Haldia Port on the eastern side, or Visakhapatnam, you have to go all around Sri Lanka. So if Setu Samudram project is, you know, allowed to be done or completed, then what will happen? It will save a lot of time between eastern and western coast, and lots of trade will be facilitated, point number one. Okay, and definitely it is between Ram Setu. Ram Setu is what is the Adams Bridge. Okay, here is the leaderboard. So when you study all this, keep Google opened. You know, so that will help you to more and know more about any subject matter. Okay, here is the next question. This is a question. This is a question of MCQ in your book. It's mentioned there. So I'm giving you all the clues. But then options certainly will not be the same. So I will play a little bit of smartness myself so that you investigate this. Okay, here is, I hope all of you have got it correct. Easy. Oh, still distributed. My God, lots of people have still. It never passes through Nagaland. Okay, it doesn't pass through Odisha. It doesn't pass through Uttar Pradesh. It passes through Madhya Pradesh, but it doesn't pass through Nagaland. It does pass through MP, but Nagaland is the wrong. It's through West Bengal. It's through West Bengal. So Tripura, West Bengal, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Gujarat. You must know all this. It's through Sikkim. My God, Srijan, come back down south. Sikkim is too up, too high, north. Okay, once again, it passes through Mizoram, Tripura. Then, what did I say? West Bengal, then Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Gujarat. Okay, these are the states, right? So you must know this. Actually, to tell you, this question was asked in civil services prelims examination. Okay, right from 9th grade stuff, 9th and 10th grade stuff. So, yep, be very, very careful. You should have these questions in your mind, that why, what happens to this and all that. Okay, this is the updated leaderboard and the next question here. Let's see how many of you do it correctly. This is beyond, little bit extension of whatever is there. Because in your MCQ, in your geography book, it's mentioned. The question has got some link there. The first chapter, question answers there. You don't need to. It's very obvious here. Very, very obvious. If you know one or two at least. Yep. So, okay. Lots of you have got it, see? Lots of. So, Mahe is in what? Puducherry, right? One of the four districts of Puducherry is Mahe. Then Karavati is Lakshadweep. Karavati is in Lakshadweep. And this is the question which is there in your book. There is a question related to, there is a friend of yours and all this. See, I'll show you. So, read like that. Oh, this is some other book. Here. So, I had picked it from here. See. If you intend to visit Karavati during your summer vacations, which one of the following union territories of India you will be going to? So, definitely if you have studied, one answer was Lakshadweep. And that was linked to that. Okay. So, hence, study deeply. Mahe. Nay. Mahe is in India. Okay. Okay. Then, yes, it's in Puducherry has four districts. Mahe, Karaikal, Yanam and Puducherry itself. Okay. Next. These were all French colonies. French colonies. So, you know, if you go to Puducherry, you will see that French feel in the city. Yeah. Okay. So, Jayant is maintaining the lead. That's so nice. And here is the next question. Standard meridian of India doesn't pass through. So, all of you pay attention only to Tropic of Cancer. This meridian should also be given importance. Guessed it. So it passes definitely through Mirzapur, UP. Oh my god, okay. So, wow, still I am really happy that most of you are, you know, correct. Right? It doesn't pass through Telangana. Okay, it only passes through. So I have the book, I have kept this open. So you can see. So here is how it goes. So here is Mirzapur, and the meridian goes like that, like that, like that, like that, but never touches Telangana. Okay, so if you Google smartly, guys. Next. Okay, so but then Jayant's position is unchallenged. Abhishek is also second position unchallenged. Very good. Next. Now, if you have researched, you would know it. But you can guess. Easy. Very good. So most of you have got it. Why is 10 degree channel called 10 degree? Anyone knows it? Why is 10 degree channel known as 10 degree channel? You can guess. Guess. Because it's 10 degree. What is 10 degree? 10 degree latitude. Very good. 10 degree north. That's correct. Very good. So 10 degree line latitude passes between north and south, the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Okay, so remember that 10 degree channel. Next question. Now in your book, if you see, I pressed it. Oh, okay. So okay. So close, finish, maybe. But before that, I would just want to highlight this to you, that please pay attention to these also. Very, very important. Map skills, very, very important. People ignore it. And these also, you know, some read through all these people generally ignore it. That should not be done. Okay, so I have picked up lots of questions from here only. Right? I know where people are not paying attention to. Here is the question based on that. Okay, go to next. Let me see how many of you know it. So there is a part in your book which says know about your state, home state. So let me see how many of you know about your home state. Googled. That's nice. I have a map, I think, opened already. Oh, that's nice. 24 people know at least about their home state. You should know about your home state. Wait a minute. I don't have. So wait, let me see. So Karnataka political map. See, can you see that? This is the northernmost state and southernmost state, right? So northernmost, southernmost. Okay, very good. So you now know. Last question. Okay, so be ready. And didn't understand. It was ready for you, not state, sir. Yeah, in Karnataka. Oh, if not from state, oh, that I can't control. Here is the last question. Oh, before that, I already showed you that, right? No, I didn't show you that. Never mind. So, okay. So let's go to the last question. Very easy question. All of you can get it correct. All of you can get it correct. Think about it. All of you can get it correct. Cool. And here is the final question's answer. Okay, so step function. I told you all of you can get it correct. All of you can get it correct. All of you can get it correct. Okay? Right? No, good. All rivers flow through Karnataka. All of them. Right? All of them flow through Karnataka. Okay? So Godavari also flows. South Pennar, Krishna, North Pennar, Mandovi, everything. Okay, so the final bell of the evening is here. Let's see who became the king of the evening. Okay, so Jayant is on first position. Very many, many congratulations to Jayant and well done. So very good, Raghav, Nishant, Abhishek, Gandhar, Parth, Vihan, Anuya, Krishna and Ashish. Well done, man. So Jayant is very good in good at quizzing, is it? Or you have already? Yep. So that's so nice. Very good. Keep it up. Keep it up. So we have just concluded the first chapter. So you see, your first chapter, geography, is over. What did we learn about India? Its area, its expanse, latitudinal, longitudinal, and prime meridian, and sorry, not prime meridian, the standard meridian, Tropic of Cancer, and the coastlines and all that stuff. Very good. So well done, guys. I really appreciate. So I hope this was useful session for you. So in a set of 50 questions. No, I haven't shared. If I would have shared, and if Jayant has got only 15,358 points out of 25,000, that means I have not done the right job or good job. Right? So if I would have given someone question, he should have been around 20,000 plus out of 25 questions. Okay, never mind. Thanks a lot for your time, guys. So we are concluding a little early, so that means I can have more questions on this thing. So what next? Geography or history? Geography or history?
Geography.
Geography only. Everyone wants geography, so we'll continue with geography.
History. Not at all history.
History and civics together. Okay.
Oh, sir, yes, civics, please.
Okay.
Sir,
okay.
Civics is please.
No problem. We'll see. Don't you think
sir,
this?
Sir, you can put general knowledge.
No whatever. We'll do whatever we'll do. All this is general knowledge only, to beyond a point, because not everything is in your book. So hence you have to explore. The idea is to make sure that you all explore. Read more or go beyond whatever is given in the book. Okay, so don't worry. Yeah. Anything else? Yes. Anyone else wants to say anything?
Sir, Tanya here.
Yes, Tanya, tell me.
Sir, actually, I came in, I think, late. So, I've just joined today. So, have I missed anything?
You have missed a lot, my dear. So, we'll talk separately on that. So, no worries.
Okay. Sure,
we'll
sir,
tell you
sir.
So okay, guys. So whatever is there next, maybe we'll tell you the topic and post the topic in the Mockstra group. You have to study that, and I will give you very less time, 2 days that is, and then okay. Fair enough. So calling it a day. Thanks for your time. I really enjoyed. I hope you also enjoyed the quiz. So your first chapter geography is done. Good job, guys. So your 50 questions, one chapter. Bye bye. Take care.